guys, today I'm gonna be making a video with some bubble wrap. I haven't seen a lot of these videos, but I always really liked popping bubble wrap, which a lot of people like. There's just something really satisfying about. My brother already popped some of these, even though I had said that I'm going to use it for an ASMR video, but he apparently hadn't heard that. But yeah, I'm gonna be popping this and just making some plastic sounds with it, and just rambling in the spoken voice in English for a change. To the center. So what have you guys been up to lately? I have a test week going on at the moment. It sucks. But yeah, I've been watching some ASMR to relax also. Today I just had my Swedish test. Today's Monday. Still 3 more tests to go. Tomorrow I have my English test, but luckily I don't really need to study for my English test because, yeah, I can just like watch Stargate or something and I can't study because I've been fully exposed to the English language. And oh, last Friday we went to see Bohemian Rhapsody, the movie about Freddie Mercury, and it was really good. I highly recommend you to see it, even if you're not a fan of Queen. It was just a great movie. I don't like listen to their music or anything, but it was just a great movie in general, even if you aren't like their fan. And I cried at the end because I'm a crybaby. Stargate SG-1 recently. In case you don't know what Stargate is, it's a sci-fi series. What a surprise! What a surprise that a serious enemy likes sci-fi. Yeah. It's basically about this secret Stargate project. USA's Army's secret Stargate project. They have this device called Stargate, with what they use to travel to other worlds, other planets. And yeah, the series SG-1, it continues from the 1994 Stargate movie. I've never seen that movie, but I really want to see it now, as I've watched the series. In the second season at the moment, although we are at the second season, me, my mother, and my brother, because we watch it together. It popped. The satisfaction of getting one of these to pop is so great. My favorite character is Daniel Jackson, because he's just amazing. He's the sweetest little thing. Also, I have a cup of tea in here. What a surprise again. It's still a little too hot. White tea with orange. And yeah, I do love all of the characters. I love Jack O'Neill. I love his sarcasm. And just, he has a great personality, and I love Samantha Carter. She's like this badass scientist lady. She's amazing. And I love Teal'c also. He is funny without trying to be funny. If you're fans of sci-fi, I highly recommend you check it out. I have this thing that it usually takes me a while to warm up to a new series, but then just randomly at some point when I watched enough, like a season or something, I'll just become completely obsessed with it. It's really weird. I'm sorry, I just keep looking down when I'm not looking at you, but I can't look at the camera and at the bubble wrap at the same time. Unless if I could like look into different directions with my eyes, but that doesn't really work. So yeah, it's a great series. Let me try. I have this sort of obsession of putting things over my microphone because it sounds Let's hope this is pretty cool. It looks pretty cool at least. Maybe you will get more of the crinkly effect if I pop them like this. I hope the popping sounds won't be too loud. But you will get more of the crinkly sounds. And I don't know if you can hear me speak. I hope you can. Underestimate the power of this microphone. Like I make sounds and I think, oh, they won't be that loud, but they will always be like really loud. So that you can hear what I'm saying. If you guys have any sci-fi series recommendations, please leave them down below because I want to be able to watch sci-fi for like the rest of my life. Sci-fi is the best movie and series genre. It's funny. Most of the things I watch are sci-fi, but most of the things I read are fantasy. But fantasy and sci-fi, they kind of cross at some points. They are pretty similar genres, but I don't read that much sci-fi. Oh well, today I borrowed a book at the library. I've only read like a couple of pages in it. It's called Violinen, Flawed in English. I don't remember the writer's name. It was a woman. It seems pretty cool. I've always loved books and I've always read them. Any kind of those romance stuff or like oh I have to my computer. The screen just went like really bright for a moment. Okay, I don't know. Maybe it's been like hacked or something. I hope not. But yeah, I've always read fantasy, like any kind of drama book or those kind of books that tell about like high school and kids over there and partying. Those have never really been my types of books. Well, maybe with a few exceptions, but mostly I read like fantasy. So like historical fantasy. Knights fighting in the forest and wolves running around, that's like my perfect book. Do you guys read? I'd be interested to know. And if you have any fantasy or sci-fi or any book recommendations, please let me know. I'm always so happy when I discover a new great series. But I have this one problem. If I find a great book, I'm just like, oh, this is great, and I want if it's like a trilogy or something. Trilogies are quite common in literature. I'm just like, oh, I want the second part to come out so bad, and it's maybe like a half a year or something till it comes out. At the time when it comes out, I have already forgotten everything about the first part because I have read so much books, or just because it's been all such a long time, and then I don't want to read the first book again. Because like it would be annoying because I've already read it, but like I might not remember all of the important things, and then if I just start reading the second part, then I might miss something important in it if I don't, like I forget characters' names really easily. I have a really bad name memory in real life also, and I forget the characters' names, and sometimes I'm just walking at the library and I'm looking at like, I've read this book. I have no idea what happened in it. I might remember the very, very, very basic idea of the book, but like that's it. And I quite often feel like I've already read all of the good books in my local libraries. It's probably not so, but I just don't discover the good books. Let's have a sip of my tea. This is really good. This is like my 4th cup of tea today. And I haven't even drank any herbal infusions, so like 4th cup of tea. I've probably gotten too much caffeine. Well, I don't think I'm that sensitive to caffeine. I just jumped from books to caffeine. Yeah, I don't think I'm that sensitive to caffeine. Like, I can drink green tea at like 8 p.m, even 9 p.m. I don't have any difficulty falling asleep. At least more than usually. I should take it off from this. I really hope popping sounds, but I'm eating that. I'm too loud. But yeah, I don't think I'm that sensitive to caffeine. Well, sometimes when I've drank like a lot of black tea, I might feel like a little hyper. That's also like part of my personality sometimes. I just feel hyperactive. I don't have ADHD or anything. At least I haven't been diagnosed with it. Sometimes you might think I have ADHD if you like don't know my personality and you just randomly see me. If I have eaten a lot of candy, for example. Everyone who's seen me after I've eaten a lot of candy, you know what I'm talking about. That was a nice pop. It wasn't too bad. Loud. Where are all of the unpopped ones? I popped everything already. teaching them soft spoken to whisper without noticing. I'm the Kermit meme now. I just should have a tea bag hanging from me. I have an English test tomorrow, and I'm recording an ASMR video. Well, it's in English, so technically this counts as studying. We have stuff like indefinite nouns and stuff like that. I don't remember if I've talked about this in a previous video, but like, sometimes I just think what my life would be like if I didn't speak English. Like, it would be so different. You don't think that speaking another language changes your life that much, but honestly, my life would be so different. Like, I use English so much every day when I talk to my internet friends or watch YouTube videos, make these ASMR videos for you guys when I can be English. Like, when I watch different ASMR, just. And yeah, like, it would be so weird to not be able to speak English. What is this pop? Oh, great. Okay, it would be so weird to not be able to speak English. Like, it's weird to think that there are some people out there who cannot speak one language. I mean, I'm not fluent in English, but I speak my native tongue, Finnish, obviously. And then I speak English. And then I speak, like, little bit Swedish, because we have to study it at school. But, like, it would be so weird, because, like, I wouldn't have had the same experiences if I wouldn't speak English. Like, I have the feeling that I've talked about this in a previous video of mine, but I just said it now because I thought about it and no one probably remembers what I've said in my previous video. I just gotta say it. I really like this color. I should get more close with this color. It's a soft moss green. I bought it from flea market, so it's secondhand also, which is also a good thing. A dog. Getting tired. Watch. Hopefully, if that's what you love, try to do. Oh, I thought it'd be generous. If that's the sign that I should stop this video now, and I hope that you guys relaxed. Yeah, tell me your sci-fi movie and book recommendations down in the comments. And remember to relax and don't stress too much like me, if that's possible. And yeah, good night or good have a good night or a good day or a good evening or a good morning, whatever the time is when you're watching this. And yeah, I'll see you guys.